हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ कुमार एंड आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पोएम, मेंडिंग बॉल, अ वेरी मैसेज गिविंग पोएम, एंड इट इज़ मेंडिंग बॉल विच हैज़ बीन रिटन बाय रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट। रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट वॉज बोर्न इन 1874 एंड डाइड इन 1963। इन माई अर्लियर ऑडियो अबाउट रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द राइटर, सो आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द राइटर राइट नाउ इन दिस वीडियो। प्लीज़ वॉच माई earlier video, that is the road not taken. In that video I have discussed about the poet. You can see that video. So today we are going to discuss this poem, Mending Bowl, written by Robert Frost. So let us have a brief introduction to the poem. So the poet has an apple orchard. His neighbor has a good land of pine trees. There is a wall that separates the land of one from the other. Every year in the spring season, the poet sees big gaps in this wall. The poet says that there is something that doesn't love a wall. The poet informs his neighbor, and the two together mend the wall. Each of them works on his side of the wall. The poet tries to impress upon his neighbor that there is no need of a wall. His apple trees can never go across to the neighbor's spines and eat their fruit. But the neighbor doesn't agree with what the poet says. He says that good fences make good neighbors. The poet has a deeper meaning also. The wall here stands for artificial divisions on the basis of caste, creed, religion, and nationality. The poet is against all these. He favors internationalism and cosmopolitanism. So now let us discuss the poem in detail, Mending Bowl by Robert Frost. Something there is that doesn't love a wall means there is something that doesn't like a wall that sends the frozen groundswell under it. Frozen groundswell under it means when due to extreme cold the water freezes and expands, it causes slow waves in the ground and these waves shake the earth invisibly. That something makes the frozen groundswell under the wall and spills the upper boulders in the sun. Spills means causes to fall over. Boulders are large stones made smooth by water or weather. Due to this, the upper stones of the wall begin to fall over and makes gaps even two can pass abreast. Abreast means side by side and facing the same way. In the sun means without worry or care. It even makes huge gaps in the wall through which two men can pass side by side. So in this stanza, the poet says that there is something in nature which does not like the existence of a wall. That something sends invisible waves under the wall. Then the upper stones on the wall fall over from the edge. It is as if someone has thrown them here and there carelessly. Big gaps appear in the wall. These gaps are sometimes so big that two men can pass through them side by side. So now let us discuss the second stanza of this poem. The work of hunters is another thing. Added to this is the work of hunters. I have come after them and made repair. I have often come to make repairs and after they have done their work of pulling down the wall, where they have left not one stone on a stone. They don't leave even one stone of the wall in its place. But they would have the rabbit out of hiding, but means so that. Hiding is the place of hiding. To please the yelping dogs. Yelping means crying, barking. So while trying to get the rabbit out of its hiding place, they don't leave even one stone on another. They do it to please their yelping dogs who have found the rabbit hiding there. So in this stanza, another thing which shows that the wall is not liked is the work of hunters. These hunters often throw down the entire wall. They don't leave even one stone on another stone. They do it to get some rabbit out of its hiding place under the wall. The dogs they have with them go on yelping to tell them where the rabbit is hiding. Then, to please their dogs, the hunters throw down the entire wall and don't leave one stone on another stone. When the poet goes there later, in the spring season, he has to repair the whole wall. The gaps, I mean, no one has seen them made or heard them made. I'm talking of those gaps in the wall which no one has seen being made or heard of them being made. But at spring mending time, we find them there. Spring is the season after winter. Mending time is the wall is repaired in spring after it has been damaged in winter. But we find them when it is mending time in the spring season. I let my neighbor know beyond the hill. Beyond the hill means on the other side of the hill. My neighbor lives beyond the hill and I tell him about these gaps. And on a day we meet to walk the line, then one day we meet to repair the wall and set the wall between us once again. We keep the wall between us as we go. We walk along the line of the wall and we go repairing the wall between us. So in this stanza the poet says that no one has ever seen or heard these gaps being made in the wall. But when he goes there in the spring, he finds big gaps made in the wall. Then he informs his neighbor who lives on the other side of the hill. A day is fixed to mend the wall once again. Then both of them meet and set the wall between them. Each keeps to his own side of the wall. They walk along the line of the wall while mending it. Now let us read the next tanja. To each the boulders that have fallen to each, both of us set the boulders that have fallen to our own respective side. My neighbor sets the boulders fallen on his side, and I set the boulders fallen on my side. And some are lobes and some so nearly bowls. Lobes means flat and thin like lobes. Bowls means round like bowls. Some boulders are flat like lobes and some are nearly round like bowls. We have to use a spell to make them balance. Spell means magic. Make them balance means keep them in their right place. Because of their different form and shape, we have to use a spell to keep them in their place. Stay where you are until our backs are turned. We have to say to them, stay where you are until our backs are turned. We wear our fingers rough with handling them. Our fingers turn rough with the handling of these boulders. So in this tanja, both the poet and his neighbor mend the wall together. Each of them picks up the stones that have fallen to his side. Some of these stones are flat like lobes, while others are almost lying round like bowls. So it becomes very difficult to balance one after the other. The poet humorously remarks that they have to use a spell to balance the stones. After they have placed a stone in its position, they say, stay where you are until our backs are turned. The poet means to say that stones keep falling down again and again since they are irregular in shape. So they have to lift them and set them in their place again and again. The poet says that their finger turned rough with the handling of those stones. Now let us read the next tanja. Oh, just another kind of outdoor game, one on a side. Outdoor game is the game played in the open air outside a building or house. Oh, it is just like another outdoor game with one player on each side. It comes to little more. There where it is, we do not need the wall. Comes to mean amounts to. Where it is means where the wall is. It is a little more than a game because we don't need the wall where it is. He is all pine and I am apple orchard. He is all pine means all his trees are pine trees. He has all pines on his side and I have an apple orchard on my side. My apple trees will never get across and eat the cones under his pines. Cones means conical fruit of a pine tree. There is no chance that my apple trees will get across the wall and eat the cones fallen under his pines. I tell him, he only says, good fences make good neighbors. When I tell this thing to my neighbor, he only says, good fences make good neighbors. So in this tanja, the poet says that their mending the wall is just another kind of outdoor game. Like some other outdoor games, it has one player on each side. In fact, it is hardly more than a game because they are raising a wall where there is no need of a wall. The neighbor has only pine tree on his side of the wall, while the poet's orchard has only apple trees. The poet humorously says to his neighbor, my apple trees will never get across and eat the cones under your pines. But the neighbor believes in the value of having walls and fences. He says, good fences make good neighbors. Now let us read the next tanja. Spring is the mischief in me. It means the poet has a lively nature and is fond of having light-hearted jokes with others. We have here a variation of the idiom full of joys of the spring, which means lively and light-hearted. When it is spring, I become playful, means the poet become playful. And I wonder if I could put a notion in his head, why do they make good neighbors? Isn't it where there are cows, but here there are no cows? Notion means idea. So, I wonder if I could put this one idea in his head, how do good fences make good neighbors? Isn't it true only where there are cows, but here there are no cows? Before I built a bowl, I would ask to know what I was bowling in or bowling out. Before I built a bowl, I would like to know what I was bowling in or bowling out, and to whom I was like to give offense. And I would like to know what offense I would be causing and to whom if I didn't build that bowl. Something there is that doesn't love a bowl, that wants it down. There is surely something that doesn't like a bowl. It wants the bowl to be pulled down. So in this tanja, the poet doesn't agree with his neighbor's view that good fences make good neighbors. He says that he wants to have a light-hearted talk with his neighbor and put one idea in his head. He wants to ask, how good fences make good neighbors? we can say such a thing only of a place where we have cows, because cows can wander into a neighbor's field and destroy the crop. But the poet says that here there are no cows to be afraid of. So he can't understand how the wall in their case can be of any use. Before building any wall, he would like to know what it was that he was walling in or walling out. He would also like to know to whom he was likely to give offense in case there was no wall. The poet again asserts his belief that there is something in nature that doesn't love a wall and wants it fall down.
And now let us read the next stanza.
I could say elves to him, Albin's plural of elf, a type of small fairy, an imaginary creature in human shape, often mischievous. But it's not elves exactly, and I would rather he said it for himself. I would rather means I would prefer.
So I would tell my neighbor that it is elves that don't love a wall and want it to be pulled down. But it is not elves exactly. I wish my neighbor himself said who or what it was that didn't love a wall. So the poet says that there is something that doesn't love a wall and wants it down. He thinks this something could be elves. But then he says that it is not elves exactly. He is not certain who or what it could be. But he wishes that his neighbor could say such a thing about himself. In other words, the poet wishes that his neighbor too, like himself, had no love of walls and fences. Then they would not have to mend the wall again and again every year.
I see him there, bringing a stone grasped firmly by the top, in each hand like an old stone savaged arm. Grasp means caught firmly with hands or fingers. Old stone savage means an uncivilized man of the stone age. The second period of the stone age is known as the old stone age, when man used rough stone implements. So I see my neighbor coming here. He is bringing a stone. He has grasped it firmly from the top. He has a stone in each hand. He looks like an armed savage of the old stone age. So the poet and his neighbor are mending the wall that separates the land of one from that of the other. Each is working on his own side of his wall. The poet sees his neighbor carrying a stone. He has grasped it firmly by the top. He has a stone in each of his two hands. The poet satirically remarks that his neighbor looks like a savage of the stone age. These lines clearly show that the poet considers building walls as a savage's ways of life. He doesn't want any divisions or partition in the life of modern civilized man.
He moves in darkness, as it seems to me. Darkness means absence of light or knowledge. Darkness can be physical as well as spiritual or mental. It seems to me that my neighbor is moving in darkness, not of woods only and the shade of trees. It is not merely the darkness of the woods and the shade of the trees in which he is moving. He will not go behind his father's saying. Go behind means give up. Father's sayings means what his father used to say. He is not going to give up the idea of his ancestors. And he likes having thought of it so well. He says again, good fences make good neighbors. Likes having thought of it so well means has convinced himself that what he has thought is right. So, and he thinks that the ideas of his ancestors were so good. And he repeats the thing again, good fences make good neighbors.
The poet sees his neighbor bringing stones to mend the wall. The neighbor is moving in the darkness of the woods and in the shade of trees. The poet says that it is not outward darkness only in which the neighbor is moving in. He has inward darkness also. The neighbor's soul has not yet come out of the darkness of his narrow-mindedness. Though he is living in the modern age, he is still savage in his ways. He is not willing to give up the old, outdated, traditional views of his forefathers. He still loves to live in his own separate cell. He still believes that walls and fences are useful because good fences make good neighbors. So here our present poem, Mending Ball, a beautiful poem, a poem with a beautiful message, finally ends. I hope you understand the poem. I hope you enjoyed the poem. And if you enjoyed the poem, then please like, share and comment on the video. And please subscribe the channel for further such updates. This much all from us now. Thank you very much for joining the lecture. Have a great day.